Hey, what's up, guys? It's Fox 2 and I am back. It's been a long time, but I am back today with another video, and today I have with me the USS Arizona, which is of course a tier 3 American premium battleship, and it is absolutely insane, but so was the price tag. I mean, the gold that I had to spend really hurt my current amount of gold that I had, that I intended on spending originally on leveling up in the ground forces. I mean, 2,400 gold. Yeah, that really did hurt my gold supply. So, if you like this video, naval players, please do subscribe to thank me for the amount of gold I literally spent on buying the ship. But so saying, I think now that I have bought it, that gold, for that gold, this ship was worth every bit of it. It is absolutely brilliant. I don't think there is any other ship quite like the ship, at least at rank 3, especially since you are often being tiered, I mean, put into battle with tier 2 ships as well. I mean, it's just a brilliant piece of work, the ship. I mean, the guns are just crazy. If you shoot just one volley, you can sometimes even knock out 40% of a ship's health, especially if they are a lower tier ship. And it also levels you up like crazy. If you just have like 3 very good battles, you can go up one level with just that amount, when in general it would take you at least 15 to 20 good battles with ordinary naval ships. I mean, that's very, very good. So instead of spending gold and leveling up, you just need the ship, just 3 really good battles, and you will level up like there's no tomorrow in the ship. It's just absolutely insane. The only drawback I really think the ship has is its mobility. It's a very slow ship, but you can understand why when you see that enormous size. I mean, look, it literally has 3 planes on the back. I know the game says 6, but if you look, the back carries 3 planes when most other ships can only fit 2 or 1 on the back. And looks like we had a guy there. Ah, nice, we've got a guy right here, we've got a guy around here. And, okay, 2 guys. 2 guys. Come on, let's cross. Nice, aim for there. And there we go, fire off. Nice, let's stop. Come on. 1%. 1%. 1%. Come on. Hit him. 1%. Come on, what is my guns doing? 30%. There we go. And set him on fire. I mean, there we have it. That insane guns once again. Just shredding enemy vessels. I mean, there, 18% and engine damage. Just one more good volley, perhaps, and I could have him out. Come on, let's aim for there. Let's go. Let's go. Nice! That was very, very fast. I mean, he had basically no time to think about it. I wonder if I can hit this guy from behind the rock. Sometimes this game allows you to hit ships from behind rocks, sometimes not. It appears not this time. Okay, he's coming round. Admiral Hipper. Let's fire for... hopefully we can hit him. Let's just try there. Let's try for there. Come on. Hit. Nice! 15% off once again. That is just crazy. There is nothing like the ship. I'm telling you guys, if you are looking for a good premium ship, you have to get this ship. It is just insane. You will not regret buying this ship and spending all of that gold on it. It's just pure joy, this ship. Okay, there. Okay, can we hit him? No, I don't think we can. And let's deal with this Admiral Hipper. I'm pretty sure we can take him down. And okay, we've got another Admiral Hipper over here. Let's fire, fire here. Can we hit him? Yes! Nice! Ooh, that hurt, that hurt, that hurt. Okay. Now we've got this Admiral Hipper to deal with. And looks like we've taken some damage. Okay, putting up smoke screens. I'm just gonna put up a smoke screen while we repair our gun. Come on. Repair the gun. Nice. Hit him through the smokes. Boom. Nice. 1% lost. Hold on. Where is he? Is he there? Okay, looks like he's not there. Come on, maybe I can find him with the help of the minimap. Is he here? Come on! Where is he? He's here somewhere. And we're being fired on from this side. Come on! This is not very good for us right now. Come on, guns, turn, hurry, guns, come on. Yes, let's start. Come on, let's go, nice. Ah, and here he is, here he is. And whoa, why is he literally not looking at us? Come on. Nice, nice. Okay. And we've got the Imperatrice Maria. Come on, right there. Nice, come on. See, can we make that hit or will it hit the houses? Okay, nice. Did some damage. Let's hit the Admiral Hipper. And wow, this is a very, very intense situation right now. And I don't know how this one is going to turn out. Come on, main guns, aim. What's taking the main gun so long? Come on, hit him, hit him, nice! That is once again the crazy power of the USS Arizona. I mean, this was one hard situation to survive, but we somehow survived it. 27% knocked off. Come on, reload. Reload. Come on, we've got this. We've got this. He's on fire. Nice, come on. Can we knock that last 27 off? Nice! Another one down. And where's that Imperatrice Maria? Somewhere there, harassing a teammate. So let's try and get around, but I've got a feeling it's going to take us forever to get there, as usual. I mean, that is, like I said, the drawback the USS Arizona does have. It is incredibly slow, and its turn rate is very poor too, so it's quite difficult navigating a lot of islands, especially on a map like this one. It's not too friendly towards the USS Arizona. Because you do struggle to steer around the islands a lot of the time. I mean, I've crashed quite a few times and run aground. Okay. Victory! First place in team. 186,000 scores. That is really good once again. And I think for most people that will be more or less average. 150 to 160,000 scores. In the USS Arizona, and yeah, first place in the team. I mean, not too surprising being in the USS Arizona and just how overpowered it is, in my opinion. So yeah, I hope in this video I could showcase to you just how the USS Arizona performs. And as always, guys, if you enjoyed this video, please remember to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks.